General Vokes, would you say that the fighting before Rimini was the hardest that the division has had?
No, I wouldn't say it was the hardest. Although I would say that it was just as hard as anything we've had in Italy.
Would you explain, General, why it was that the division got through the Gothic line with such speed and then was held up on the Conca River and after that had such a fierce battle for Rimini?
Well, I think there's, generally speaking, a mistaken view about the Gothic line. It was a defense in depth, stretching from south of Pesaro to Rimini. The Foglia River and its minefields and fortifications were really only the outpost zone of the Gothic line. I think the Germans would have liked to make their main stand there, but although they had a lot of pillboxes with panzer turrets, there weren't enough of them. They hadn't had time to prepare it properly. This was shown by the panzer turrets we found that weren't even mounted. Then, of course, we caught them by surprise. Although the rest of the Gothic line hadn't been as heavily fortified as the Foglia River, it had been thoroughly surveyed so that the Germans were able to put up a strong artillery defense all the way back to Rimini.
Then the breaking of the Gothic line and the opening of a passage into the Lombardy plain can be divided into two phases, the first ending with the Conca River and the second with Rimini.
Yes, that's right. The division had a good deal of trouble getting through the minefields on the Foglia. One battalion got stuck, but another battalion got through when an officer of this battalion showed great gallantry and leadership. He crawled on his hands and knees through the minefields, and his men followed him in this fashion.
The tanks were used in this phase, weren't they, sir?
Tanks were used throughout, and the infantry and tanks cooperated to a degree which was close to perfection. That was one reason why we got to the Conca so fast.
In the second phase, the drive on Rimini, the division attacked the dominating hills to the west of the town.
The Canadians in the 1st Division did a left hook, while a Greek mountain brigade, which was under my command, moved along the coast. We had some very heavy fighting for the high ground, which the Boche clung to with great tenacity. The Fortunato feature was particularly difficult, because it was so steep. However, we finally got over it and established a bridgehead across the Marikia River. Then the game was up and the Germans pulled out of Rimini. By the way, there's a good story in this connection. A German officer we caught said that he didn't consider that the Canadians fought fair because we'd attacked them from behind.
Would you single out any unit in the division for special mention, General?
No, I wouldn't want to do that. You see, in battle, a lot depends on the breaks that a unit gets. Every battalion in the division fought brilliantly. And if I were to select any one unit for praise, I'd say it would be the 21st British Army Tank Brigade, who've been working with us for a long time now. The tanks did a wonderful job, and they were always willing to go anywhere. Didn't matter how tough it was.
The division has been fighting for a long time now, and there have been a lot of changes. Do you think it's just as good as the division which fought at Ortona?
Yes. We've learned a lot since then. The division takes great pride in doing a job of work thoroughly and well, no matter how tough it may be.
Thank you, sir.